Hello dear students, so we have discussed the two laws of the Kirchhoff. Now let's come and solve a numerical problem. So I will do for you how to apply the Kirchhoff first and second law while solving the numerical problems. So this is a question I have taken for example. This is a circuit diagram given to you. 1 ohm, 4 ohm, 3 ohm, 2 ohm, 5 ohm, and unknown EMF, say battery of unknown EMF, say E. The question is, you need to calculate the equivalent resistance. Okay, so now let's see how to solve this question. So first of all, just before starting the question, just denote the current. The currents are not marked in the circuit. We can assume the current by ourselves. Okay, so let's, if I take as total current is given as I, and let if some part of the current, say I assume that I1 goes upward, and the rest of the current, that is I, is approaching towards the point and I1 is going away from the point. So just by applying the Kirchhoff first law, you will get rest of the current as I minus I1. So I is approaching towards I1, is going away from a point, you will get as rest of the current as I minus I1. Okay, so first of all, in this, till here we have current I1, and from here also you have current, say I minus I1. So in this part we have denoted it. Let if I say that again, some part, say I2 current is flowing to the 4 ohm resistor, and again by Kirchhoff first law, through this I1 is approaching towards point and I2 is moving away from the point. So as per sign conventions, I will get here I1 minus I2. This is the current through the 3 ohm resistor. Now here again I1 minus I2, and here we have I minus I1. So you need to calculate total current going through the 5 ohm resistor. Again, one is moving towards, one is, this is also moving towards. Both get added, I1 get answered, I will left with I minus I2. I minus I2. Okay, so ultimately, you can also check, because finally if I go this point, here I have I2, here I have I minus I2. So again, if you want to calculate current through this outer circuit, so I2 get cancelled, we are again left with the total current, say I. So you are assuming total current to be entering to be I, and obviously total current exiting the main circuit should be equal to I, and that we have verified. So this is the very first step, how to denote the current flowing through the different branches and how to assess yourself whether you are taking current with positive or negative sign in a wrong way or in a correct way. This is to assess. You need to calculate what is the total amount of final current that is emerging out of the circuit, and that should be equal to the total current that is entering through a circuit. So this is the very first step. Okay, this is the usage of Kirchhoff first law. Now we come to the second step, that is Kirchhoff's second law or a loop rule, right? If I take again, suppose I will take loop like this, okay, first circuit. So parallelly I will write the equations also. So suppose I have first loop is M, C, D, M. So I am applying the equation in loop M, C, D, M. So see, in this, there is 1 ohm resistor, there is 3 ohm resistor and 2 ohm resistor. No battery source in this circuit. So we are taking loop as clockwise. Okay. So this current is also clockwise, 1 into I1 first, I into R, right? 1 into I1. Again, in this also current is with the loop, so positive, plus 3 times I1 minus I2. Right, and in this, now see, This is the current, that is why anti-clockwise, but move is clockwise. So now comes a negative sign. 2 times I minus I1. No battery source, and this equation will reduce to the 0. Right? Just to solve the equations, just collect the I1 terms and I2 terms, you will get as 6I1 minus 3I2 equal to 2I. So this is the first simplified equation in NCTM. Okay? So now, second, that is CNBC. Again, in this also, I will take clockwise loop, for example. You can take anti-clockwise too, no problem. This we need to take care of sign conventions. Okay? So if I take clockwise loop, again in this also we have 4 ohm resistor, 5 ohm resistor and 3 ohm resistor. 3 values are there actually. Okay? So see, 4 ohm resistor, current is flowing towards in favor of loop. So this is a positive term, 4 times I2. Then I will come to the 5 ohm, right? So current is anticlockwise. So here comes negative sign, 5 times I minus I2. Okay, and again in this also current is against the loop, so we will have minus 3 times I minus I1 minus I2 equal to 0. So this is a second equation, and after solving you will get minus 3 times I1 plus 12 times I2 equal to 5 times I. This is a second equation. Now a simple mathematics. You can solve equation number 1 and 2, and after solving equation 1 and 2, I am writing the final values. I1 equals to 13 by 21 times I. This is after solving the two equations. And similarly, I2 we will get with 12 by 21 times I. So these are I1 and I2. Now, we will frame one more equation, okay? Because you remember how much the number of unknown parameters you have, that much equations you must have. In this also I1 and I2, 3 unknown variables we are working with. So you should have 3 basic equations, right? If I go with one more equation, saying now outer loop, in outer loop, like this. Now in outer loop, say I am taking A, M, D, and B, A, outer loop. Okay, so outer loop we have 2 ohm resistor. So going with the loop, the 2 times I minus I1, again 5 ohm resistor. Going with the loop, 5 times I minus I2 and equal to, or now a battery source is there, E. So this is the third equation you will develop. And in this equation, you will put I1 and I2. Put the values of I1 and I2 and solve. I will write here the final equation. I will comes out to be 12 by 21 by 61 times E. In terms of E, this is a total current. 21 by 61 times E. Right? Now, you have simple expression that E equal to IR. Okay, total potential drop. E equal to IR. We have calculated for I, just put out the value of I, 21 by 16 times E, right? And you will get R. R will be 16 by 21. Right? This is 21 by 61. Alright. So this is the final value you will get after solving. So my main purpose is to tell you how to mark the currents in the loop, how to assume the loops in the closed circuits, and how to develop the equations in a closed circuit. Rest solving is quite simpler. Right? Solving of the equation is quite simple. You need to frame the equations very carefully as per the Loop's assumption. So I hope you are now clear with the how to apply the Kirchhoff's first law and second law to solve for complex problems. So I will come with some new concept in the next lecture. Thank you.